It's quarterfinal Sunday, and here in Chapel Hill, the champions of the two major conferences square off with a Final Four berth in the balance. It's the ACC champion, North Carolina Tar Heels, and the Big Ten champion, Iowa Hawkeyes. The 2019 Division I Field Hockey Championships here on YouTube. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to a windy day here at Karen Shelton Stadium as North Carolina, the number one seed and undefeated team in Division I field hockey, is ready to start things off. As you see, Carolina is wearing all navy blue with Carolina blue letters and numbers. Iowa is wearing white with gold letters and numbers. And the starting 11s for both sides, no changes made from the first round wins that both of these two sides have. North Carolina having Amanda Hendry in goal on the back line, Madison Orobono, Romay Ricardo, and Courtney Williamson. In the midfield, players like Megan Duvernois, Eva Smolinars, Jenta Lehmans, and Feline Gunter. And up in attack, you've got Catherine Hayden, Marissa Creator, and Aaron Mattson. For Iowa, Leslie Spate is in front of the cage for the Hawkeyes. On the back line, you've got Locus Stribos, Anta Nizel, and Esme Gibson in the midfield. You have Katie Birch, Sophie Stribos, Ellie Holly, Sophie Sunderland, and Nikki Freeman. And up in attack, Leah Zellner and Maddie Murphy. North Carolina were 4-0 victors in their first round game on Friday against the Stanford Cardinal. Jenta Lehmans getting things started early for the Tar Heels off a corner. Then goals in the first half by Feline Gunter and Aaron Mattson made it 3-0 at halftime, and right at the end of the game, Mattson added a second to make it 4-0. Iowa was the second game. They played the Duke Blue Devils and came out as 3-2 victors against Duke, holding on to their lead. They had a 3-0 lead at halftime. Duke scored twice in the second half as there's this entry into the circle dealt with by the Carolina defense. The Iowa defense held on to win that game by the score of 3-2, and Sierra Smith, who came off the bench, was the star. Two goals and an assist, contributing to every goal that the Hawkeyes scored. Now, this is one of four quarterfinal games taking place simultaneously across the country. The other quarterfinal games taking place in Storrs, Connecticut. The number two seed UConn Huskies hosting the Princeton Tigers, the Ivy League champions, against the Big East. You've got another ACC Big Ten matchup in Charlottesville as the number three seed Virginia Cavaliers host the Maryland Terrapins. And then in Louisville, Kentucky, the number four seed Louisville Cardinals host the Boston College Eagles. Boston College was the runner-up in the ACC tournament that they hosted just a week ago. As we said, North Carolina comes into this game with a record of 20-0, the ACC regular season and tournament champions. Iowa coming into this match at 17-4, and they finished with a record of 7-1 in the Big Ten. The ball is hit out, and it will be taken up by Iowa and Nikki Freeman. Lance Sarabia and Ayanna McLean are our match officials. As there's a foul just outside the circle. Iowa really pressing North Carolina early on in the opening minutes. Sunderland on the restart. Good defending though by Gunter on the quick entry by Freeman. And now Jenta Lehmans, the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, trying to get it up the field. Hits it out of play. It's gonna be These two sides really mirror each other quite well. They're both aggressive offensively and they're very stout defensively. And they have players up and down the pitch that can cause a lot of damage. in terms of their positioning and in terms of their play style, and none bigger than number one for North Carolina, Aaron Mattson. Mattson has been on a scoring tear. 26 goals and 15 assists in her sophomore campaign for 67 points. Mattson tied the great Charlotte Craddock with 26 goals in 2012, the most goals ever scored by a sophomore under head coach Karen Shelton. And she's a couple goals away from taking second place all time in North Carolina history for most goals in a season. Iowa already making changes as number 17, Sierra Smith, who we mentioned earlier, contributed to all three goals that Iowa scored yesterday, is on the field. The ball is hit out by Carolina, Locus Stribos. Her and her younger sister, Sophie, coming from Belgium. No shots yet. It's been a very evenly paced, trying to find each other's weak spot in this opening quarter. As Hayden deflects the pass, ball recovered by Marissa Creator, one of the captains and local product from Chapel Hill. But she slipped on the turf field and goes out of play back to the Hawkeyes. Gibson tried to keep it alive, but is called for the infraction. Quick restart by Ava Smolinars, and Aaron Mattson charging up the field. Foul on the dash side of the circle. And now Megan Duvernois will restart it. Back to Lehman's. Mattson, the ACC Offensive Player of the Year, facing a double team. Solid defense, though, by Katie Birch, the unanimous all Big Ten selection on the first team. Iowa had two other players named to receive all Big Ten honors. They included Maddie Murphy, the attacker, and Anta Nizel was named to the second team on defense. And she's going to be a handful, her and Katie Birch, against the likes of Aaron Mattson. We mentioned on Friday, Nizel stands at 6 foot tall, right in front of Leslie Spate, as Smith could not control that long pass, and Carolina will take it at midfield. Lehman's, Ricardo, sharp pass to Duvernois, deflected and controlled by Iowa with Sophie Sunderland. Now here's Katie Birch. Nice awareness from the captain from England. Now it's picked up by the Tar Heels, and they try to get it up the field towards Marissa Creator. Excellent defending by Esme Gibson on that far sideline. Dealing against both Creator and Mattson. Mattson reached in, delayed whistle, and now the whistle will blow. A great contingent of fans from both sides here at Karen Shelton Stadium. So we are past the midway point of the first quarter. And Duvernois called on the foul as a couple more changes coming in. Megan Conroy, number 5 for Iowa. You also see Bryn Boylan and Abby Pitcairn, as well as Riley Fulmer, ready to check in for the Tar Heels. Duvernois, Lehman's dispossessed by Birch. And can Iowa get a quick counterattack going? It's 2-on-3, though. And it looks like Leah Zellner will hold things up and gets a whistle right at the 22-meter mark. Freeman. Murphy sends it in. It comes to the center, controlled by Stribos, and it went off her foot last, and as Carolina tried to get it out. It was last deflected by Iowa. And Gunter will lay it off for Ricardo as Ricardo rips that down the line. Though out of play. Again, sometimes you see these sharp passes and it's more of a positioning mechanism than just being a reckless attempt at hitting the ball down the field. As you see Carolina trying to get their high press going. That's how they were able to get some good chances against Stanford. And it's been a staple of head coach Karen Shelton in her 39th season as the head coach at North Carolina. 689 wins in her 39 years and 7 national titles, including last year, as Murphy sends the ball in a circle, deflected, and it will stay with Iowa as it was last touched by Madison Orobono against a charging, I believe it was number 21, McKenna McGuire, who's come in for the first time. Here's Murphy, again, trying to get that direct ball in so it can be deflected. McGuire too close to the near post as Murphy went far post. Ricardo back to Orobono. Now Lehman's. And Ricardo couldn't keep it in. Quick response from Iowa. Here's Conroy. What an interception by Lehman's. As we said, the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, that holding mid that can be part of the back line when called upon. And now Mattson, what dribbling skills. She tries to get by Birch. Oh, she's gonna be whistled as she tried to get around the Iowa captain. And again, Lehman's just picking balls off as they try to get past, as Iowa tries to get past the lines. North Carolina just running into trouble, not really able to get an attacking chance going. Still no shots registered, and we are in the 12th minute. Very tactical, gritty game so far. These two sides have played each other usually at the start of the season. They've been a part of the ACC Big Ten Challenge, and they've played each other every year in the ACC Big Ten Challenge at the start of the season since 2002. And they played earlier this year in Ann Arbor, Michigan, who hosted the challenge. And it was the Tar Heels that came out as 2-1 victors. But it was a very difficult game for North Carolina. And we'll get to that in just a moment as Bryn Boylan is pressing forward for North Carolina. But she's picked off by Esme Gibson. And Duvernois called for the infraction. North Carolina was down 1-0 against Iowa after the Hawkeyes scored on a corner in the third quarter. And then they pulled Hendry with about 10 minutes remaining. And that, coupled with a yellow card penalty issued to Iowa's Esme Gibson, allowed North Carolina to tie the game and then from Catherine Hayden and then win it with a goal from Marissa Creator with 2.5 minutes remaining. Mattson. Smolinar's Gunter was wide open, though no one was there to put a shot on target. Gunter, though, will keep it alive on the far side. First real chance for Carolina if they can play it right, but then that's excellent defense by Iowa. I believe that's Nikki Freeman. And now Sierra Smith trying to press and get speed on Courtney Williamson, but it's a good closeout. Carolina trying to develop their offense by getting out wide and hitting sharp balls into the middle of the circle. Pitcairn looking towards Mattson. Izzell battling with Mattson, and it's going to be the sophomore from the Netherlands that's called for the infraction right at midfield. So we are just over a minute remaining. Lance Sarabia, the referee, telling Smolinars to step back. And again, he's asking at the spot that he calls it. And also when he's ready, and now he's ready. Pitcairn back to Ricardo, trying to loft it towards Mattson down the side. Good control, though, by Katie Birch. and good fending off against Mattson. We know how Mattson loves to try to win the ball back when the ball's taken away from her. And there's an entry ball into the center. North Carolina gets on the ball, and Smolinars will look to put one up there. Hayden, direct pass across Mattson, and she couldn't get a stick on it. Best chance we've seen in the game so far is Leslie Spate, the keeper for Iowa, was on an island as Mattson charged in after the sharp cross from Catherine Hayden as the horn sounds. Very methodical first quarter. No shots for either side. No goals for either side. We got a great game here at Karen Shelton Stadium. It's the quarterfinals of the Division I Field Hockey Championships on YouTube. Getting set for the second quarter here in Chapel Hill. No goals, no shots from either side. North Carolina making its 36th appearance in the NCAA tournament. Overall record of 67-28 all time. That's number one in games and number one in wins. And at home they've been, it's been a fortress here, 29-2 in NCAA tournament games here in Chapel Hill. Iowa, meanwhile, making their 24th appearance in the NCAA tournament, 27-24 all time. And we mentioned how North Carolina has won 7 national championships. Iowa has won 1 national title, that being in 1986. Pass from Smolinar, picked off by Freeman. And good connections by Iowa's Maddie Murphy gets by Orobono. Delayed whistle, Orobono lost her stick. And a ball just went past the end line right at the end. Actually, it was last touch by Carolina, so they'll take it back at the 22-meter mark. Sunderland to Holly. He's looking for the run from Freeman. Iowa's led by head coach Lisa Salucci, who is in her 6th season as the head coach at Iowa. Got her 70th win on Friday in the win against Duke. But Salucci has been part of Iowa for both her college playing days and as a coach, as an assistant coach, has been with the program since she was the all-time leading goalkeeper in the history of Iowa field hockey. 3-time All-American, nearly 600 saves in her 4 seasons, and a member of the U.S. national team When she joined the coaching staff in the late 90s, she was initially a recruiting coordinator and then an assistant coach. And then she was given the job in 2014. And she's really built this program in the best way as Holly and Murphy brings it up into the circle. Went off a foot, corner for Iowa. The first real chance for either side tonight. It comes with 12:42 remaining in the second quarter and created by Maddie Murphy. A little too aggressive by, I believe it was Ricardo or Williamson, one of the defenders for the Tar Heels. So Iowa will set things up with the first corner of the match. Maddie Murphy will deliver the insert. Got Locus Stribos and Ellie Holly. And seeing how they line up, everyone's standing out. Ready to receive. Murphy. Holly, Stribos low, deflected and in! Iowa gets on the board first, and I believe it's number 9, Sophie Stribos. The sister-to-sister connection puts the Hawkeyes in front here in the 17th minute. A picture-perfect corner. As it was delivered by Maddie Murphy, controlled by Ellie Holly. And then Loka Stribos didn't fire it on cage. Sophie crashed the cage. And the older sister found the younger sister and just tipped it in. And that's where we stand. 1-0 in favor to Iowa. Foul just outside the circle. And it's actually been called on Carolina, as the Tar Heels were looking for a quick response. As we said, the Hawkeyes, the champions of the Big Ten tournament, sixth all time. They were co-regular season champions with Maryland, their 13th regular season championship, as Sierra Smith trying to spin away from Williamson. Smith, good defending by Orobono, a young freshman defender out of Pennsylvania. It's a very young Carolina defense with Orobono and Ricardo as freshmen. Williamson, an experienced junior, but she's been getting more and more starts recently as Carolina lost Ashley Hoffman, the National Player of the Year. Her jersey was retired at the end of the 2018 season by the Department of Athletics and the field hockey team. And their other star defender, Cassie Sumfest, tore her ACL in the spring. That's why Carolina's been playing with a very young back line. As Gunter gets a whistle, and Smolinars will lay it off to Ricardo. And the young freshman gets things started again as Lehmans spins away from trouble and finds Williamson. Duvernois on the far side. Down the line it goes, Smolinars keeps it in. Sharp pass in. A good chance by Creator and stopped by Spate. And Iowa will clear it only as far as Duvernois. Second wave coming, Gunter. Pass was tipped and it came off the arm just outside the circle. First real chance for Carolina after one at the end of the quarter. Sharp ball in, and it came off of Mattson's leg. And she is gently hopping on that right leg, trying to shake off that pain as the field hockey ball is not, it's a very tough ball. That's why they wear those long pads over their socks. Try to absorb that contact. And Mattson still gingerly running. Gunter fouled just right at the edge of the sideline. They'll take it back with 9.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Gunter, Creator over in the corner. Good defense by Iowa. Advantage played. I believe it was Esme Gibson that got a stick there. But they can't get it past midfield as Gunter try to bring it inside. Ball is too far in front of her. And Iowa just hits it off of Smolinar's and it's back to the Hawkeyes. Iowa has performed really well at the end of the season. As one of my former coaches would say, it's peak time. They've won 6 in a row and 7, and actually 8 of their last 9 games. As Ricardo tumbles over, counter open for Iowa if they play it right with Maddie Murphy trying to get it to her teammate, but lost the ball as she tried to pass it off. Duvernois trying to push it up to Mattson. But there's Katie Birch to step in the way.
Substitution for the Tar Heels, number 16, Abby Tickhart. Also for the Tar Heels, number 26.
Ball tipped by McKenna McGuire, and now Orobono in trouble against Sierra Smith. Carolina having some difficulty trying to get it out of their own half. But look at the dribbling skills from Yentl Lehmans. Trying to find Smolinar too far in front. Murphy trying to find a way through. Delayed whistle and the advantage played. Birch out wide and it's last touch. Actually a whistle was called. And it's a free hit to Iowa. Conroy picked from behind by Mattson as she tried to send a pass in. And the Tar Heels get a whistle. Actually, that last shot yet to that Creator had was not credited as a shot, so only one shot in this match so far. And it's on the penalty corner goal scored by Sophie Stribos in the 18th minute. Assisted by Loka Stribos. The two sisters working together. They also had an older sister that played here at Iowa from 2010 to 2014. Zellner. Defended well by Pitcairn as Carolina making changes. Fulmer back in. Now Ellie Holly back in for Iowa. As Locus Stribos tried to find Murphy down the sideline.
Substitution for the Tar Heels, number 10, Carlin.
Seeing players getting quick bouts of rest from both sides. Knowing that both coaches want to keep a sharp rotation. Being aggressive when it counts. As that's a great pass, and now Mattson with space to attack. Up against Nizel, gets by the center back, into the circle. Corner given to North Carolina. As Nizel was trailing after getting beat by Mattson, she tried to get back into the fold. But the Iowa defense concedes the corner, and now Carolina with a good opportunity here to level the score up at 1. As we said, Tar Heels scored their first goal of Friday's win against Stanford from a corner. They've scored 29 goals this year off of corners. And it's going to be Pitcairn. We'll deliver the insert. Orobono and Duvernois ready to receive. Orobono to Lehmans, to Mattson, sharp shot, it's in! And we're tied at 1! What a strike from Aaron Mattson, but I believe the referee, Lance Sarabia, made the video motion. So this goal will be checked. The Iowa players were looking for a referral. And so the referees are going to come right below where our camera position is. We won't be able to show you the referees looking at the monitors, but the referees do have a good number of monitors of viewpoints to look. Here at Karen Shelton Stadium, there are 6 video cameras all across the field, 4 on each light post and 2 right behind behind each respective cage. So Lance Sarabia, Ayanna McLean, and the third official is Jade Carvalho. They are going to look to see if the goal is good. Right now it's still 1-0, but if it is good, it will be credited to Aaron Mattson, receiving the pass from Yento Lehmans. It was a great setup on the corner, going one way and then the other, which allowed Mattson to fire that sharp shot into the cage. But again, the goal is under review, as it will give time for the coaching staffs to talk things over, as we have 5:27 remaining here in the first half. This is the third time that both teams, Carolina and Iowa faced off in the NCAA tournament. The first time since 1999, when Iowa won at their home field in Iowa 2-0. The lone time Carolina won against Iowa in the NCAA tournament was in 1994 at the Final Four. And they won that game by the score of 4-1. So again, the last goal is under review, and the referees are definitely going to take their time. We mentioned on Friday some of the other games that were taking place. The big one was in Louisville, Kentucky, that Louisville and Michigan, Louisville thought they had tied the game at 1. The Wolverines were up, but the Louisville goal, they thought the game was tied. That review lasted for nearly 10 minutes, and then the goal was disallowed. Louisville was able to tie it up in the second half and then win it in overtime, and that's why they're still in action. And we'll try to get you some score updates as well. I mentioned that 2 of the top 4 seeds were pressed to overtime, including the number 2 seed, Connecticut Huskies. They were pressed to push by the Fairfield Stags, the Northeast champion, and they had to come back from a goal nil down to win 2-0. We can update you right now that Connecticut and Princeton are goalless, as well as the games in Louisville between the Cardinals and the Boston College Eagles. And it's also goalless between Virginia and Maryland. So now it looks like the referees have made their decision. They are talking to both the coaches. And the goal has been confirmed. And we are tied at 1. Aaron Mattson will be credited with the goal. It's her 27th of the season, assisted by Yenta Lehmans. Lehmans now with 14 assists on the year. And as we said earlier, the number of goals that Aaron Mattson has scored has been absolutely remarkable. 27 goals in now her 18th game. And we mentioned she's only played 18 games because Aaron Mattson is a member of the U.S. Women's National Team, the senior team. And at the end of October, She competed in some friendlies with the national team for a couple of weeks, and she was able to make it back to play for the Tar Heels right at the ACC tournament. And you see her trying to find Feline Gunter. Gunter couldn't control it. That's just how impressive of a career that Erin Mattson has had. As we said, two-time ACC Offensive Player of the Year. First time, she's also the second freshman to ever be named a first-team All-American. And with that goal, she is now tied for second all-time along with Bashi Buba and Kristen McCann with 27 goals. And we are tied up at one. Free hit for North Carolina is Orobono. Finds Pitt Karn, who tries to hit it down the line. It stays in play. Hayden trying to give chase, but too much pace on that long pass, but it will allow North Carolina to get their shape going. Again, when you see those long passes, it's more for the team to get themselves shaped defensively and instill some pressure and recover it in the opposition's half. Smolinars, Orobono, Ricardo. Looking for options up the field, has to switch it to Orobono. Pressured though, and it's good awareness by Orobono against a charging Maddie Murphy. Pitt Karn, back to Williamson. Square pass, and now it's Gunter. Trying to back down against Freeman. And Zellner, and it's Zellner who's called on the whistle, and Zellner's gonna run off, and Sierra Smith will come in, as well as Yenta Lehman. She got a quick break after the assist she created off the corner. Williamson again trying to go up the field, looking for Mattson. Creator trying to give chase, but again, it goes out of play. Just under 2.5 minutes remaining. North Carolina 1, Iowa 1. Nizel. Iowa trying to shift the defense over from one side to the other. Holly, Freeman. Back to Stribos. Look at Stribos. Can't see space in between that Carolina defense, and now gets it to Holly, who links up with Sunderland, and now Holly will go down the sideline. Up against Gunter, almost nutmegged Williamson, but a foul from behind gives the free hit to Iowa, and again, Lance Sarabia pointing to the spot of where he wants the hit to be taken. Stribos trying to get a direct ball in. Birch got a hit, so did Holly. It's controlled by Sierra Smith at the edge of the circle. Now it's a dribble back out to control it. And now Smith against Pitcairn gets by a defender. And a reach in gives a free hit to Iowa just outside the circle. And it looks like Sophie Stribos will restart things as we are under a minute to go. Finds Birch. Couldn't find Smith. Lehman's gets it out of trouble. Into the corner. Duvernois. Actually, Pitt Karn just hits it out of play. Quick restart by Iowa as Gibson charges into the circle. Finds a teammate, and that's a great chance by Smith. Just missing it on the right side of the post. Excellent run by Esme Gibson, the defender who took the ball from the, when it was hit out of play, into the danger zone. And a simple pass almost yielded a second goal for Iowa. Final seconds as Williamson will try to keep it. On the far side, gets a whistle, and that will be the first half. What a half it has been here at Karen Shelton Stadium in Chapel Hill. Iowa getting on the board in the 18th minute on a sister-to-sister connection on their first penalty corner from Locus Stribos to Sophie Stribos. But then Carolina equalized in the 25th minute with the 27th goal from Aaron Mattson on a simple pass from Yentl Lehmans. So we are at halftime here in Chapel Hill. It's North Carolina 1, Iowa 1. The Division I Field Hockey Championships right here on YouTube. We'll be back in about 10 minutes with the second half.
Thank you.
We get set for the second half here at Karen Shelton Stadium between the number one seed North Carolina Tar Heels and the Iowa Hawkeyes, knotted up at one apiece. And the second half is underway. Goals were scored by Sophie Stribos and Aaron Mattson, both coming off penalty corners. And not a lot of shots from either side in the first half. Very methodical, very tactical, very aggressive, very defensive type of match. Here's Gibson trying to get the ball into the circle. Went off of Williamson's stick. Holly trying to fight for it. And they were looking for a corner, but it's whistled on Iowa as Orobono tried to get it out. Picked up by Sophie Sunderland. Not a lot of changes made for either side. Actually, only one, and that's Carline Ghost, number 10 for North Carolina, has come into the game for Yento Lehmans. As the Tar Heels try to go down the field, Marissa Creator trying to create opportunity. She said North Carolina, the defending national champions, 20-0 on the season. They've won 43 consecutive games, which is a program record. And the number one team in the country, Iowa, coming into this game with a record of 17-4. They were ranked sixth in the final coaches poll, and they were ranked eighth in terms of the RPI. But it is a battle between the two best conferences in Division I field hockey. The ACC sent six teams to the tournament field, and the Big Ten sent four. Winner will go to the Final Four, which will take place next on this coming Friday. Not far from here at Winston-Salem, North Carolina, the home of Wake Forest University. Ellie Holly getting the ball into the circle. Holly trying to cut it back, and she was trapped on the byline, loses it, and Carolina will get out with Ava Smolinars. Ghost can't get a handle on it. Sunderland was looking for a whistle, didn't get it. Creator was looking for Mattson there. But Laka Stribos finds Nikki Freeman. Now Maddie Murphy. Backhanded pass across the circle, but no one got a stick to it. And so it will be Carolina ball. One of the things that we've mentioned on Friday's broadcast was North Carolina has been in 23 Final Fours in their historic career, as Mattson trying to get away from Gibson. Loses out on it. Foul on Sunderland. Free hit to North Carolina. And they've made the Final Four every year since 2009. And a win here would take them to their 11th consecutive Final Four. Iowa as a program has made 11 Final Fours in the program's history. And we got a whistle, and a green card has been shown. The first green card of the match shown to number 7, Ellie Holly, with 10:47 remaining in this third quarter. And Carolina is now a man up for the next 2 minutes. Could this yield dividends? A card foul yielded dividends in the regular season matchup at the start of the year up in Michigan for the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Iowa was up 1-0, a yellow card penalty, which is a 5-minute man-up situation, along with pulling the goalkeeper, allow the Tar Heels to score not once, but ultimately twice right at the end of the match. And it gave Carolina the 2-1 win. Mattson, Smolinars. Fell down, she tried to pass it. Whistle was called. Now Ghost. Back to Ricardo. Trying to find Mattson, does at the edge of the circle. Marked by Stribos, and it's last touched by the sophomore. Back at the 22-meter mark. Sharp pass in by Ricardo. Gunter tried to control it in the circle, tipped out by Birch and by Freeman. And Iowa gets it out as Sierra Smith, who is quick sub off the bench for Lisa Salucci. Trying to pressure Smolinars, but Smolinars finds it to Orobono. There's about 40 seconds left in the man advantage. Pitcairn, Smolinars, give and go as Pitcairn tries to get it out wide down the line to Catherine Hayden. Pass is just too sharp. Two balls on the field. We'll stop the clock here. Just over 9 minutes remaining. 20 seconds left in the man advantage. As Ellie Holly was shown a green card. Quick restart by Megan Conroy. Picked off by Williamson. And Williamson gets a whistle. And she will lay it off and allow Smolinars to bring it back in, but Ellie Holly back onto the field. We are at even strength after the 2 minute green card. As Gunter tried to find Hayden, and it's down the far sideline. North Carolina again winning 7 national championships. In 80, winning their first title, Karen Shelton winning her first title in 1989. And then the mid-90s was really a dominant time for North Carolina, winning in 95, 96, and 97. They didn't win their next title and then until 2007 when they went undefeated for the season. And then winning it again in 2009. And as we said, during this 10-year stretch of Final Fours, they've made it to the national championship game 7 of the 10 times. Just shows that right now in this decade, Karen Shelton and North Carolina is the program in field hockey as Mattson, a star recruit, drives in. And it's Nizelle that's called on the whistle, and I believe a card is going to be issued. It is a green card to the sophomore defender, Anta Nizelle, as Mattson tried to break her down. She did the same thing as she got a corner in the second quarter, and that allowed Carolina to tie things up. So again, with 7.5 minutes to go, we're at the midway point. Tar Heels are a man up. Gunter trying to take on Freeman and Birch, and it's last touched by Birch, so Tar Heels will take it at the 22-meter mark. Smolinars, Ricardo, last deflected, delayed whistle, second pass into the circle, out by Stribos. And now Birch will back down against Ricardo, 11-on-11. And Birch, as we said, the unanimous All Big Ten selection, the central midfielder now playing defense with Nizelle in the box with that green card infraction. Stribos, Sunderland, 4-on-1 as they try to box her in, but ball went off of Hayden's foot and allows Iowa to bleed a little bit of clock. And a quick pass by Stribos and a square ball by Birch, and Iowa trying to evade Carolina. And they do so here with Megan Conroy against Abby Pitcairn and Smolinars. And she gets a whistle. Zellner will now bring it down the field on the quick restart. 30 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Ball into the circle area was Holly. And last touch by Holly on the foot. And it will be a free hit to the Tar Heels. And there is no update from the SID, but I believe from the coaching staff, Yentl Lehmans has not returned to the field. The ACC Defensive Player of the Year may have picked up an injury. And so that's why you see Megan Duvernois and Ava Smolinars trying to take the role of what Yentl Lehmans does as that central midfielder. As Nizelle is back on, the man advantage is over. Centering pass from Gibson. Again, it's tipped. Hendry got a hand on it. And I believe a stroke has been given. A penalty stroke may have been given. Trying to get the initial call. I don't know if it's a corner or a stroke, but the team is huddling together. That looks like it is a corner that is given. Usually with a referee signal, it's two fingers. I originally saw one from Lance Sarabia, but he makes the call that it is a corner. Second corner of the game for Iowa. They scored last time on the corner with 5:06 remaining. Maddie Murphy will deliver the insert. Along with Birch, Stribos, as well as Freeman. I have to look to see which wide players will crash. Nizelle trying to back down against Ricardo. It's given out wide, and that's a poor corner by Iowa. Really didn't get things going after that initial pass from Katie Birch to Nizelle. One shot so far in this third quarter. Iowa out shooting North Carolina 3-1. As Smolinars picks off Sunderland's pocket. And now Creator against Gibson. And it's the English defender that tips it out of play and allows Iowa to get back on defense. It's both teams looking to make changes right below us. As Smolinars lofts it up, Boylan keeps it in. And that was a golden chance for North Carolina. It seemed like Iowa had just given up on it, that it was enough speed on the turf that it would have gone out. And now Esme Gibson is pulled up. The freshman defender from Worcestershire, England. Looked like she may have tweaked something. But she says she's okay. Giselle to Gibson. Pitcairn with good defense. She tries to back away from Gibson as the advantage was played. And here's Esme Gibson finding Sierra Smith. Has an option at the edge of the circle. Finds Maddie Murphy, though it's behind her. Keeps it alive, corner given. All that created from the young freshman Esme Gibson. Pushing the ball up the field. Finding Sierra Smith. Smith finding Murphy. And Madison Orobono got too close to the first team all Big Ten attacker, Maddie Murphy, and concedes the corner. Third corner of the game, second of the quarter for the Hawkeyes with 3:30 to go here in this third period. We mentioned how these two teams have played twice in the postseason, and a lot of the time since 2002 at the beginning of the season. The last time Iowa defeated North Carolina was in 2016. It's Maddie Murphy with the insert. Sharp shot by Birch, stopped by Hendry, cleared out, And a whistle is called. And it's given back to Carolina. Good stop by Amanda Hendry. The second team All-ACC keeper got down low and covered a vast majority of her cage to prevent Iowa from taking the lead. Mattson getting around defenders. Pushing out the field, delayed whistle. And it'll be taken just outside the 22-meter mark as Smolinars on the quick restart. Trying to find a teammate. Picked off by Ghost. Back to Orobono, and now Tar Heels will recycle. Williamson. Pit Karn, double teamed. Lost control and yields a free hit to Iowa. And Pit Karn will come out for Duvernois. Sophie Stribos, the goal scorer for Iowa, comes out, and Ellie Holly is back in. Both teams really set in their rotations and their substitution patterns. As Gunter was trying to see a run from Creator, will go past the end line. As we said, all four quarterfinal games taking place simultaneously here in the Division I Field Hockey Championships. We'll try to provide some score updates in just a moment as Creator gets a whistle. Here comes Gunter down the end line, try to cut it back. And it was last touched by Iowa. We'll take it back to the 22-meter mark. Smolinar. Out the foot of Murphy. Centering pass in, no one touched it, and Spate just kicks it out. Again, a pass from outside the circle has to be deflected by a Carolina stick in order for a goal to be scored. And as Lucas Stribos talks to the official, we will give you some score updates. It's UConn 0, Princeton 1 up at Storrs, Connecticut. In Charlottesville, Virginia, early in the fourth quarter, it's Virginia 1, Maryland 0. And in Louisville, Kentucky, the Cardinals and the Boston College Eagles are tied at 1 apiece. This game tied at 1 apiece as we're into the final minute of the third period. Conroy, delayed whistle, trying to find Sierra Smith. And the follow through on the hit yields the free hit to the Tar Heels. Duvernois down the sideline looking for Creator. Excellent defense by Loka Stribos. Good job, though, by Creator on the recovery. Concedes a foul. Conroy down the sideline up against Duvernois. Charging towards the byline, the edge of the circle. Just under 25 seconds remaining. Trying to keep things going, but runs into Ricardo. Cleared out only as far as Sunderland. And there's a whistle and a free hit for Iowa. Again, Lance Sarabia, the official, asking for where he wants it. Obviously, certain players want to get things going again, but sometimes they're at the mercy of the referee. But the horn sounds. It's the end of the third period, and Amanda Hendry came up with a critical save on a penalty corner from Iowa that keeps things knotted at one apiece. We head to the fourth. You're watching the 2019 Field Hockey Championships here on YouTube.
Thank you.
Getting set for the fourth quarter here at Karen Shelton Stadium in Chapel Hill. North Carolina 1, Iowa 1. And as we said, it's been a very tactical game between the two sides. Two shots for Iowa in the third quarter, zero for North Carolina. As Katie Birch will get things started off here with the fourth quarter. And again, Yentl Lehmans, the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, has not returned. She may have picked up an injury right at the end of the first half. And so Carline Ghosts and Ava Smolinar is taking her position as Carolina with a good chance. Creator redirected in! Feline Gunter! Gives the Tar Heels the lead. 2-1 in favor of Carolina on great ball movement. And Feline Gunter has been on a bit of a hot streak in these last few games for the Tar Heels. Now her fifth goal in the last five games. On a brilliant bit of offense. The sharp shot by Marissa Creator. And just tapped in on a charging Feline Gunter right at the cage. And now what does Iowa do? They've been playing so well. And their shape was so solid, so strong. And in just one moment, in the flash of a snap, Carolina cut through the Iowa defense. Creator was wide open, and a sharp shot to the far post was redirected in by the senior from Germany, Feline Gunter. And it's given the Tar Heels a 2-1 lead early in this fourth quarter. We mentioned earlier in the broadcast how when Carolina was down a goal, they pulled the keeper with 10 minutes remaining, was able to get the tying goal and then the winning goal in that fourth quarter. And now can Iowa do the same? How will they be able to pressure North Carolina, get a chance for a set piece? Ball picked off by Duvernoy against Sophie Stribos. Mattson to Hayden. And the ball is hit back by Iowa. And it will allow Iowa's defense to get its shape together. Orbono trying to find Hayden. It's past her, but it's into the path of Creator. And Gibson does well against her, just deflects it out. The Creator with a quick restart. And again, whistle against the Tar Heels. Free hit. Lisa Salucci, the Big Ten Coach of the Year. And her coaching staff really being taking things in, knowing that they've got to break down Carolina again if they want to push things to potentially overtime, as Whistle is called on the Tar Heels. Clock has stopped here with 11:16 to go as referee Ayanna McLean calming things down. She made one call, Lance Sarabia. The other official overruled, and so ball's given back to the Tar Heels. Nizelle backing down against Creator. Last touch by the player that right now has the game-winning goal, Feline Gunter. And here is Gunter receiving that backhanded pass. Went off of Creator last. And Sunderland will restart things for Iowa. Sophie Stribos trying to go down the side, looking for Leah Zellner, and it's just past a stick reach. Ten and a half minutes to go. Riley Fulmer, number 26. For Carolina, checks into the game as the ball's picked off. Centering pass by Birch. Not controlled by Zellner, and it'll allow Carolina to get it out of their own half. Gibson up against Fulmer, gets a whistle and a free hit. Sunderland evades Duvernois. Back to Stribos. Birch. Forward pass to Ellie Holly. Off the foot of Ricardo. Free hit to Iowa. As Nikki Freeman will lay it off for Birch. Three in the circle. Off the foot of Hayden. Restarted by Birch. All Big Ten player gets it back to Stribos. Sharp hit in. Deflected. And it was last touched by Ricardo. Off her stick, Iowa will take it at the 22-meter mark. Sunderland gets it out wide to Gibson, who cuts back into the middle. But Gibson runs into trouble as Mattson picks her off. Was trying to look for a free hit. Didn't get it, and now the ball is given back to the Hawkeyes. Centering pass deflected by Williamson, and she gets it out to Smolinars. Smolinars trying to dribble out of trouble, and what composure by Smolinars. Gets it back to Ricardo, the junior from the Netherlands, taking the role that Jenta Lehmans has done the entire year, her fellow countrywoman. But Iowa still trying to get that equalizer. Centering pass goes through across the circle. It's Carolina ball. We are just at about the midway point of the fourth quarter. North Carolina 2, Iowa 1. Both teams ready to make changes. When they get a chance, the whistle is on Iowa. And the pressure from Iowa forces Orobono to hit it out of play and give it back in a dangerous spot. Gibson trying to attack Fulmer, gets a free hit. Holly back to Gibson. North Carolina so congested inside their own third that Iowa has to pass it back out. Stribos, sharp ball. Whistle and a foul just outside the circle. Birch will take it in. Shot was tipped by Mattson. And it's back out to the 22-meter mark. Under 7 minutes to go, Sunderland Locus Stribos, again, forward pass tipped by Smolinars. Recovered by Williamson, though she lost it, hesitated. And it's out by the Tar Heels. Iowa will still keep it in the attacking third. Here are the Let's Go Hawks chants from the Iowa fans. A good contingent of Iowa fans have come here to Carolina. Gibson. Sophie Stribos, the goal scorer for the Hawkeyes. Gibson try to get it in towards the circle, and Fulmer will just get it and boot it long. Mizell has to run all the way back to her own half, and it allows both teams to make changes. Sierra Smith, Marissa Creator in for both sides, as well as McKenna McGuire coming in for Iowa. Stribos. Actually, it's Birch. Back to Stribos. Nizel. Gibson. That pass was not crisp enough, but she's able to get a whistle. And a quick restart from the freshman from England. Slips it into space for Sophie Stribos. Holly. Trying to find Birch. It's into the circle, out by Williamson. Birch, though, picks it off and recovers it. Keeps it for Iowa. Down the sideline. Gets by one defender. Centering pass. Holly backing down against Gunter. Holly's shot is over the bar. And I believe it was last touched by Hendry. That's what the referee said. And it's given back to Iowa. 5 minutes to go. Hawkeyes are knocking on the door after an early goal. 26 seconds into the fourth quarter by Feline Gunter. Has made it a 2-1 lead for the Tar Heels. Nizel, Sunderland. You wonder at what point will Iowa pull Leslie Spate, the keeper? So there's a foul on Carolina just outside the circle. Sunderland will just hit it back to Nizel. Stribos. Centering pass to Birch. Trying to get by Gunter. It's now Holly. Holly trying to hit it off of Gunter. And they were looking for a whistle. But they're not going to get it. Actually, they're going to get something out of it. Going to get the ball back at the 22-meter mark. Nizel, Gibson. Gibson trying to attack Creator, and that's good defending by her and by Ghosts. As now they'll use Ava Smolinars to try to get out of trouble, trying to chip Gibson, can't do it. Here's Esme Gibson trying to drive. But again, Feline Gunter doing well defensively and getting a free hit out of it. And you see Karen Shelton waving things down, saying, calm down, let's run some clock before we restart things. Just over 3 minutes to go. Square ball from Orobono. Williamson there to take it. Now Duvernoy finds Creator. Last touched out by Gibson. Clock is stopped, and they are going to take out Spate. As you see at the top of your screen, the Iowa keeper running to the bench. They're going to bring in an 11th attacker. Iowa going all out here. And the clock is still running. And the clock should be stopped as referee Lance Sarabia made the X sign to stop the clock. So the clock will have to be reset. It's been reset to 2:55. And it's Carolina ball right in front of the Tar Heel bench. Duvernoy will just get it back to Williamson. Final four at stake. For North Carolina, it will be their 11th consecutive Final Four. For the Hawkeyes, it will be the 12th Final Four in program history. Good dribbling by Mattson. Draw some woos from the Tar Heel fans. And now look at her holding things off, holding multiple defenders off, and almost using a burst of speed to break down the Iowa defense. But again, she runs off that time, precious time that Iowa desperately needs. Gunter. Dribbles it out. Here's Birch. Fouled by Gunter. Again, a sharp pass. And delayed whistle gives it back to Iowa at the 22-meter mark. Under 2 minutes to go. North Carolina 2, Iowa 1. Stribo centering pass, deflected. And Ghost brought down Sierra Smith just outside the circle. Quick restart by Birch. Holly, good defense by Gunter. The German midfielder. who has scored the winning goal right now, is doing things very well defensively. As there's the whistle on the Tar Heels as Mattson tried to send it long. Quick restart picked off by Smolinars. And a whistle on Holly. So we're now under a minute as Locus Stribos cannot control that long lofted pass. Mattson will just take control. Try to slow things down. Back down against defenders. And look at Erin Mattson just taking her time and shredding her way against Iowa defenders that desperately want to win the ball back. As again, she's just taking it backwards. And now Ricardo will try to dribble out the clock. For the 11th consecutive year, the North Carolina Tar Heels are headed to the Final Four. The perfect season continues. North Carolina is now 21-0 on the season. And those were 60 well, hard-fought minutes against the Big Ten tournament champion Iowa Hawkeyes. Sophie Stribos for Iowa got them on the board early on in the second quarter. They were pegged back by Erin Mattson on a corner, and then 26 seconds into the fourth quarter, the North Carolina offense tore apart Iowa's defense, and a sharp shot by Marissa Creator was redirected in by Feline Gunter. She scores the game-winning goal, her fifth goal in the last five games, and the Tar Heels are taking the drive to Winston-Salem in the Final Four. So far, our entire crew here at Karen Shelton Stadium. I'm Brian Ware saying thanks again for watching the 2019 Division I Field Hockey Championships on YouTube, where the number one North Carolina Tar Heels and defending national champions have now won 44 consecutive games and are two wins away from back-to-back national titles. They take it 2-1 over the Iowa Hawkeyes. Thanks for watching.